Nicole here from Spellbinders, and I'm excited to be showcasing some beautiful projects from Becca Feakin of Amazing Paper Grace. Specifically, we're going to be looking at some dies from her Candlewick collection, as well as her Vintage Treasures collection. So let's get started. So here are two of the dies we're going to feature in this demo. This is her Grand Pocket, and you'll notice that it is grand, in fact, it is quite large, but it also has these three flowers, Cinchingo flowers that come with it, which we will be using later. And we're also going to be using the Candlewick rectangles. I'm going to put the rectangles aside for now, and we're going to go ahead and cut out our pocket. So something really of note about this die is that this edge over here is actually a score line. So if you feel it with your finger, you'll note it's not a cutting, it's actually a score. And then we have the perforated line here, which also creates a score line. So when you're cutting out your pockets, you're going to want to use really an oversized piece of cardstock. And so basically just eyeball it. You can measure it if you want, but I'm going to go ahead and cut it right about here, and I'm going to tack it down. And I'll show you why we have this kind of hang up the top and over here in just a second. So we're going to run that through our die cutting machine. There you go. Two passes through usually does it. This is a pretty easy to cut die. Now I'm going to bring my trimmer in. I'm going to trim off some of these sections off this top part. Just bring it right down to there. There you go. And then I'll do the same down here at the bottom. Just a tiny bit there. There we go. You can feel it. It comes loose really easily. Okay, so we removed this piece. And now what we're going to do is trim off this strip because you won't need that. And then we're also going to measure from the perforated line up to 5.5 because this is going to fit a 5.5 or A2 size card insert. So let's go ahead and trim off the excess down here. And again, get just right to it. There you go. Cut that strip off. And then we want to measure to see how tall this is. And so again, we want this to be 5.5 tall. So here we are 5.5 and just shave off a little bit. It's a lot easier when you do start with a slightly oversized piece of cardstock because you can always trim it back down. Now ultimately I'm going to trim this as well, but I do want to score it first and see how my pocket's looking before I do that. So again, here's a tip about this pocket is you're going to want to reinforce those score lines. And doing that will just make it so much easier for you to fold. So find yourself a ridge here that aligns with the score line. And you can see it. It's kind of tough to see on camera, but I can see it from my angle. So I'm just going to drive my crease tool into that score line to give me a nice crease. And again, these pieces are very delicate, so it helps to have that reinforced score line to be able to curl that around without hurting the delicate die cut. So there we have it. Now, is it starting to look a little bit more like a pocket? Cool. And then now we're going to fold up this perforated line. Doesn't need the reinforcing as much as the other. And there we go. So now it looks like a pocket, right? But we need to trim off this excess. So again, A2 size card, we'll go ahead and trim this down to fit our A2 size card. And now we have a beautiful pocket to hold an insert. So now that the pocket's done, let's switch gears and pull out our Candlewick rectangles die to do our insert. So I have some cardstock already pulled here. I'm going to bring in the largest of the dies here. So we have an outside cut line, and then we have this beautiful, delicate Candlewick detail. Now, because of the delicate nature of these die cuts, the trick here is really to cut your outside frame first, which is sized to an A2 size card, and then come back and cut out your delicate inside piece. Now, this one is a little bit trickier because there's a lot more cuts to it. So you'll have to run this one through a few times, and sometimes you even need to rotate the die as you do that. Okay, so we have this beautiful cut. So now I want to show you something. Just like with all of the Candlewick dies, the beauty of these basic shapes happens when you emboss it. If you just run it through the die cutting machine, it looks like this, and it's quite beautiful. So this is purely die cut. Now, this is when you cut and emboss. So can you see the difference here? There's some really fine Candlewick detail that you capture when you run it through the embossing step.
Again, your choice if you'd like to do that or not, but if you are going to do that, then make sure that you keep your die adhered to your cardstock and then bring in your embossing mat and plate and run it through and you'll get this look. So in doing that, we have this beautiful embossed candlewick rectangle. We backed it with a piece of buttercream cardstock and then layered on this cute little printed piece. And that is our insert. Now, that is beautiful on its own, quite nice, but we want to add a little bit more. We want to decorate the outside of the pocket. And for that, I want to bring in those three dies that I talked about earlier. All right, so the beauty of all of Becca's Cinch and Go flowers is that they generally come with more than one flower size, so sometimes three, sometimes four, and they all are very notable because they have this circle in the middle, and that's how we're going to cinch them up, as it were. So we cut out these flowers, and this is what the shapes look like, which are quite beautiful, but we're going to shape these flowers, and I want to show you the types of shapes that you can do, because you can do very different looking flowers based on how you mold them. So this is the type of flower we're going to do now for our pocket, but I want to show you how cool and how versatile these dies are, because you could also create one more like this that's more of a closed or rosebud type. So we're going to focus on this one for now, and I'm going to give you a few tips on how to do it. Now, first of all, we need to get our petals shaped, and for that I want to bring in an acetate sheet or kind of a clear sheet just so I don't get my mat wet. But you could do it on the table, you could do it on anything, and because you are going to need some water. So I'm bringing in one of Jane's Misters here. Now the key for the type of flower that we're doing is to turn these over. So we're going to turn them over and we're going to give them a little spritz, nothing crazy, just a little water, and kind of get them in there. Get them in that water. And then we'll move them to our mat for the molding stage. So a little bit wet. And I'm going to add them to the mat. And I'm going to bring in the tool-in-one with the stylus tip head. So you're all familiar with the tool-in-one. We use it all the time to get our chads and things out of dies. But there's also a set of stylus tips that you can add to it that is perfect for flowers. So again, the flower, the die cut is turned upside down. And we're gonna just add some pressure here and just bring it in from the outside in to the center. And just doing that, give it a good amount of pressure a handful of times. And you see here, you're kind of starting to break down those fibers and those petals are starting to curl up a bit. Now the key for this flower then is to turn it around and then to hit it here in the middle. And that causes it to kind of curl up like that, okay? So we'll set that one aside. Again, it's upside down. Do the exact same thing. There you go. And then turn it over and boom. So you're starting to see how it's coming together, right? This one's obviously teeny tiny and curls together quite easily. So now we have our shaped petals. Now the key though, before we start to assemble, is to let them dry thoroughly. So I'm gonna go ahead and set these aside and let them dry for a minute. And while we let them dry, I do want to give you a quick tip. If you wanted to create one, a flower that's more of the closed variety, it's really the same process. The only difference is that you're going to want to have the petals right side up when you do that same process. So you get them damp, you put them here, and then you're going to be doing the same process, adding that pressure, drying those petals in, breaking down those fibers to get those to curl up. And then your final step, of course, will be hitting the center again. It kind of brings everything together and kind of closes the bud. So see, it's already starting to try to close. And you can also use your fingers to get in there and shape it too, because once it dries, they're pretty hard. I mean, they're pretty stiff little flowers. So the key though, again, is to let them dry before you start working with them to assemble. Okay, so let's switch over to assembly now. Now again, these ones actually aren't quite dry yet, so I'm gonna bring in some that we've already done that are dry. So here's a few that we have that are already dry. So we have our die cut pieces. Now, you need to have some type of a stamen. And stamen, of course, is the center of the flower. And so what we've done here, these are quite simple. This is just 26 gauge wire with a little pearl bead on the end. So, you know, just little pearl beads.
and you're gonna give yourself a lot of room to work with. So cut your wire extra long, slide your bead on, and then just twist it up. And as you can see, we have all these little stamens created. And it helps to do these, you know, in bulk too. So sit down and do a whole bunch of these, and then you have them ready for when you want to assemble your flowers. So we will start with the smallest, of course, and we'll slide that on. Now you can use regular white glue, it works okay, but the hot glue gun gives it extra structure, but it also creates kind of a buffer between your first and second and third levels of flowers, which gives your flower a lot more dimension. And then you're gonna add your next one. Now when you add your next one, you want it to be offset. So you're gonna wanna line it up so that your petals, see that? So your petals are kind of offset between your big and your little one. Now make sure that you come in and you add a final dollop of glue on the back that will really hold it in place. Because ultimately you are gonna trim down this wire and you don't want the petals to be falling off. Now I do wanna show you as well, you could just a single one, and this acts as a really great filler as well. This is with that different look folded up, but you can do multiple petals, you can do just singles, and these again act as really great fillers if you're building kind of a bouquet on the front of your project. Now you'll notice there is a lot of delicate kind of lace working in here. So here's a little tip for you. Add a little circle or some type of a die cut back here that'll act as really our surface to adhere our flowers to. So as I mentioned, when you had your wire, it was always a little longer because we were working with it to add the glue, but now we can trim it down. So go ahead and trim it down. And then you just add them to the front of your piece. Now I want to give them something to lay on, so I created a cute little bow here. You can just grab any of your favorite ribbons and do that. And we'll just add our bow here, and then we'll add the flowers on top. Then you're going to want to close up that pocket. Now there's two ways to do it. You could wrap the flap around the back. Many people don't like the look of that. They don't like the showing. And so what you'll do instead is add your adhesive here, and then it will fold up right here to close up your pocket. Either way works. It's really personal preference. And then you slide in your A2 card.
So I am really happy with how this adorable pocket turned out with those cute flowers. And just simply add your sentiment on your note card, slide it in, and anyone would love to receive that.